Have you ever forgotten to pay a bill because you simply relied on your memory? We've all been there, I know. You see all these reminder and task list apps available for download, but wouldn't it be nice to just have one tool that could send you reminders and help you pay your bills while you're at it? Well, luckily, QuickBooks Online does exactly that. So today we're diving into a super useful tutorial, how to pay your bills using QuickBooks Online. Whether you're a construction business owner or just someone trying to keep your finances in order, this step-by-step guide will make your life a lot easier. Trust me, once you get the hang of it, managing your bills will feel so easy. If you're currently DIYing your books right now and have been using QuickBooks Online, then this is the perfect tutorial for you. But of course, nothing beats having someone else take on this task so you could focus on other activities that will help you generate more revenue. Whether you're looking to continue with DIY process or you want to outsource and still understand the way this works, keep watching. So let's get started. All right, the first thing you need to do is log into your QuickBooks Online account. If you don't have an account yet, go ahead and set one up and also set up the bill pay function of QuickBooks Online. QuickBooks Online is a fantastic tool for managing all your business finances in just one place. I have a separate tutorial on how to set up your account on QuickBooks Online, which I will link below in the description. So step number one, entering your bills. Now, before we can pay any bills, we need to enter them into QuickBooks Online. Go to this new button. This is your go-to spot for creating new transactions. Select bill under vendors section. This will open up a new bill entry form and you'll need to fill in the details of the bill. So let's use a real life example. Imagine you got the bill from your topsoil supplier for $2,000 worth of materials, right? You can use either category details or item details. I like to use items. We would find the topsoil in here. We will plug in $2,000. You have to choose the vendor that you're gonna be purchasing from. Let's say it's gonna be Ace Hardware. Why not? Enter bill date and enter due date, which will do the same. Bill number, we already have amount type. You can put in any sort of description for detailing the bill. Make sure to outline the project you're working on, not the customer. So for example, if we're working with Joseph Smith, we want to pick the project, not the customer. So we're gonna pick the project, and depending on what your end goal is, you can use or not use the billable expense, you can use or not use the markup. It all really depends, because many of my clients are running different types of operations. It could be cost plus, it could be cost plus fee, fixed price, fixed fee. So whichever you do, that is what you would need to develop a process for. And once you filled out all the details, you're gonna be clicking save and close. Now your bill is recorded in QuickBooks and you are ready to move for a payment.
Step two, reviewing your bills. Before we pay any bills, it's a good idea to review what you owe. This helps ensure you're not missing any payments and it keeps your cash flow in check.
So navigate to expenses tab on the left menu. It will take you to all of your vendor transactions. You click on the bills and check out your unpaid bills. And here's the bill that we just created and we marked it due today. So that is where you will find all of your outstanding bills. And then another way is to pull the report. You just go into reports and you type accounts payable, agent detail, or just agent, and you will see all the outstanding bills as well.
Take a few minutes to review this list. Make sure all your bills are recorded correctly and that you're aware of the due dates. This step is very important, especially for busy construction business owners juggling multiple vendors and projects. Step number three, paying your bills. All right, now let's get to the good part, paying your bills. Here's how to do it.
First, you go to the plus new button and then you're gonna click on pay bills. Select the account, basically choose the bank account you're paying from. This could be your business checking account. So we're gonna do the checking account and select the bills to pay, which is the bill that we have created. And you'll see a list of all of outstanding bills if you have them all. You can pay multiple bills at once. If you have the funds available, just check all the relevant boxes. Then you're gonna be entering the payment date right here.
And then you're just going to click on schedule the payment if you want to use QuickBooks Online, or you can do save and close.
And just like that, your bills are paid. QuickBooks will automatically update your bank account and expense records. Let's talk about a real life scenario. Suppose you're managing a large construction project and you have multiple suppliers to pay. Here's how you can handle this efficiently in QuickBooks. Enter all your bills as they come in. Don't wait until the last minute. As soon as you receive a bill, enter it into QuickBooks. Or if you have a bookkeeper or plan to hire one, make sure that they do this first. Second, review your bills weekly. Set aside some time each week to review your outstanding bills. This helps you stay on top of due dates and manage your cash flow. Third one is prioritize payments. If cash flow is tight, prioritize bills based on due date and any potential late fees. QuickBooks make it easy to see which bills are due soon. For example, you might have a bill from a concrete supplier due next week and a bill from an equipment rental company due in 3 weeks. Prioritize the concrete supplier to avoid any late fees and keep your project on track. Step number four, setting up recurring payments. QuickBooks Online also allows you to set up recurring payments, which is a huge time saver for regular expenses like overhead costs such as rent and utility bills. Here's how you can do it. Go to gear icon and select recurring transactions. This opens up the recurring transactions menu, and then you're gonna click on new and choose bill. Press OK to set up a new recurring bill. You gotta fill in all the details, just like when you enter a new bill, fill in the vendor, the amounts, the frequency. For example, if you pay $500 for your office rent every month, you can set the frequency as monthly. This ensures that your regular expenses are always accounted for and you don't have to manually enter them each time. It's just one less thing to do and worry about, and it helps keep your books accurate. Be very careful though using this feature, because I see a lot of times people forget to cancel recurring bill and it creates a big inaccurate balance in accounts payable. So step number five, tracking payments and reconciliation. After you've paid your bills, it's important to track your payments and reconcile your accounts. This keeps your financial records accurate and helps you catch any sort of discrepancies that happened very early on. For example, if you paid that $2,000 bill to your lumber supplier, you should see a match and transaction in your bank account. And if everything lines up, you're good to go. If not, you might need to investigate that further.
So go to the banking transactions tab. This is where you will see all your bank transactions, and then you will be able to match them. QuickBooks will try to match your bank transactions with the bills you entered, but you got to be careful because QuickBooks suggestions sometimes are not very good to refer to. So review these matches and make sure that they are correct. And then you also need to reconcile monthly at the end of each month all of your bank accounts. And this means comparing your bookkeeping, your QuickBooks records, to your bank statement to ensure that they are matching.
Now let's talk about some common mistakes to avoid when paying bills in QuickBooks Online. First of all, not entering bills immediately. Waiting to enter bills, it can lead to missed payments and late fees. Make it a habit to enter bill as soon as you receive them. Second one is not reviewing bills before payment. Always review your bills. Double check the amounts, the dates, and vendor details. Another one is ignoring recurring payments. Setting up a recurring payment can save a lot of time and prevent missed payments. Don't overlook that feature. By avoiding these common mistakes, you can keep your finances in order and avoid unnecessary headaches. You can also watch my quick 6-minute video on what to avoid doing on QuickBooks Online. Before we wrap up, here are a few other tips on paying bills in QuickBooks Online easier. Use automation. Take advantage of QuickBooks automation features whenever it's possible. This includes recurring transactions and automatic bank feeds. Stay organized. Keep your bills and receipts organized, whether digitally or physically. This makes entering and reviewing bills so much simpler. Another one is regular check-ins. Set aside time each week to review your finances, because that helps you stay on top of your bills and manage your cash flow effectively. If you've hired a bookkeeper or you're planning to, it's best to set aside time with them regularly, either weekly or monthly. And that's it. Paying your bills in QuickBooks Online doesn't have to feel like a chore. With these steps, you can streamline the process and keep your finances in great shape.
If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up, comment below with any sort of questions, and don't forget to subscribe for more tips and tutorials. And if you have anything you'd like me to create a tutorial on or video for, place it in the comments section too. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.